CBS is about to celebrate its 60th anniversary. From 1927 to 1947, you watched the radio. Then along came television. This week, we're going to take a look at some of the great shows that you've watched on CBS the past 40 years. In the old days, most shows were shot in drafty old stage theaters. Then William Paley, founder of CBS, decided he wanted something more. Not a single theater, but an entire television complex. And so in 1950 began construction of Television City here in Hollywood. What a view! I've never been that close to smog before. I'm sure you'll all find it fascinating that enough concrete was used in this building to form a highway 8.5 miles long, 20,000 cubic yards. More than 100,000 square feet of linoleum was used. It was a special broadcast premiering the grand opening. Oh, boy. What I do for a living. Here we are in Television City's legendary Studio 33. Many great shows have been shot here. Jack Benny Show, Carol Burnett, Red Skelton. Currently, of course, The Price is Right. And I'm a loser. Legend is that Jack Benny had this studio constructed to his own specifications, with the seats sloping so that the cameras would have an unobstructed view of the stage. We have a clip now of Jack Benny appearing at the groundbreaking ceremonies for Television City in 1952, 35 years ago.
I hate to disagree with the mayor of Los Angeles, but there's no oil under this building. Now, ladies and gentlemen, for the benefit of our people at home watching the show, I would like to explain the how big the CBS Television City really is. Now, these buildings here, this magnitude, you know, in fact, we have this model made for that, you see. Now, these buildings cover an area of approximately 63,000 square feet. And the air cooling system alone could make, I would say, about, well, 600 tons of ice per day, or enough to keep Phil Harris and Highballs for one entire evening.
One of the first and most critically acclaimed dramatic series to emanate from Television City was Playhouse 90, performed live. The award-winning script of Requiem for a Heavyweight by Rod Serling came to life in this studio.
Look here, Mace. Now look at his pupil. You see, that's known as sclerotic damage. You see that tissue? A couple of good solid rights to that eye, and you can get him a seeing eye dog. Or maybe it won't happen to have that way. Maybe some night he'll bang his head on the bathroom door and bleed to death. Either way, Mace, could happen either way. No more. Mountain and I will both retire this week.
What do you mean?
No more. He's through.
For one show, The Old Man, from a story by William Faulkner, they even flooded the entire studio to get the desired effect. Tomorrow, we'll relive some of the great moments in comedy and variety shows. Here, at Television City, the pilots for All in the Family, Maude, and the Jeffersons were all taped, as well as 11 years of the Carol Burnett Show. By the mid-1960s, nearly all shows were shot in color, and most of them were on videotape so they could be edited. The variety show was flourishing. Even Sonny and Cher had their own show. And here they are in a scene with their offspring, whom they chose to name Chastity.
Babe. I got you, babe. I got you, babe.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, everybody. God bless you.
The 60s, of course, was a decade of revolt. And here at CBS, the network had a problem with some of its performers trying to outdo the local censors. The Smothers Brothers, for example, gave them a lot of trouble. Now, in this scene, keep an eye peeled for an early Steve Martin.
Good script.
Nothing funny in this. Hey, boys, we're through censoring your show.
By the early 70s, the variety show had just about reached its peak. Carol Burnett was still flourishing as she is today.
What brings you to Tara?
You vixen, you. Starlet, I love you. That gown is gorgeous.
Thank you. I saw it in the window and I just couldn't resist it.
With the decline of the variety show in the early 70s, there was a rebirth of the situation comedy, thanks mainly to creative talents like Norman Lear. But the new sitcom was quite different from the days of I Love Lucy and Life with Luigi. No longer did we have those innocuous slapstick shows. Now, we were offered controversy, as in All in the Family.
Things are no different now than they ever were.
What are you talking about? In my day, get your feet off that fringe. In my day, we was able to keep certain things in a proper perspective. Take keeping company, for instance. Your mother-in-law and me was going around together. It was 2 whole years. There was nothing. I mean, absolutely nothing. Not till the wedding night.
Yeah, and even then.
Subjects that had previously been taboo were now treated openly, such as the sexual revolution, rape, abortion, as in that episode of Maude.
We're free. We finally have the right to decide what we can do with our own bodies.
All right, then will you please get yours into the kitchen?
You're just scared.
I am not scared.
You are, and it's as simple as going to the dentist.
Now I'm scared.
Listen to me. It's a simple operation now. But when you were growing up, it was illegal. And it was dangerous, and it was sinister, and you've never gotten over that. Now, you tell me that's not true.
It's not true. And you're right. I've never gotten over it.
Racial and sexual stereotypes were addressed in the Jeffersons.
George, why do we have to fight so much? If we have a problem, why can't we just talk it through? Like Tom and Helen, they don't fight.
They don't fight because they're scared to fight.
What's that supposed to mean?
You know damn well what it means. If you two ever really started going at one another, inside of 5 minutes, he'd be calling you...
Don't say it.
Nigger.
He said it.
Listen to me. We've had lots of fights, and it's never happened.
Oh, and don't tell me it never crossed your mind.
No more than it ever crossed my mind to say the word hunky to Tom.
Ha! Well, how come you said it just then?
One of the standbys of old-time radio was, of course, the soap opera. I beg your pardon, the continuing daytime drama. That popularity, of course, has been transferred to television. I'm sitting right now on the set of the prize-winning, number one-rated television soap, I beg your pardon, daytime drama, The Young and the Restless. Who knows how many romances have been consummated on this very couch? I'm getting a little excited just sitting here. An Another popular daytime drama taped here at Television City is The Bold and the Beautiful. We've seen many memorable moments from some of the shows that were done here in the past and some that are being taped today. As for the future of Television City, or of television itself for that matter, your guess is as good as mine.